Hello YouTube and welcome to Antirex on Gaming. This is going to be a first impressions video slash review of an upcoming MMORPG called Devillian. Now this is a game that's originally from Korea and it's actually been in Korea for about 3 years. I've taken a look at this game maybe about a year and a half ago by playing on a Korean server, but today I'm going to show you what it's going to be like on the American server when it comes out. And this will be through Glyph, which is one of the account management softwares from Trine Worlds, a company that's also responsible for games like Trove, Arcage, and Defiance, and Rift. Now anyway, so let's look at the character creation first, and then I'm going to show you what it's like when you actually just start the game. Character creation is relatively simple. There's really just four classes: Evoker, Berserker, it's coming up any second, there he is, Shadow Hunter, there you go, and Cannoneer. So these four classes are quite unique, but at the same time, the gameplay will not be particularly different, because other than the skills, you'll be doing pretty much the same thing. You can kind of see what the gameplay is like here. And essentially, this game is going for sort of a Diablo-like perspective. Now, Cannoneer is obviously a gun-wielding character. Shadow Hunter has this sort of a whip that he uses to both disable opponents, but also to do some AoE damage. Then you have Berserker, which is a melee character. And lastly, we have Evoker, which is the wizard type with a lot of disabling attacks and a lot of crowd control. I've decided to start with Evoker. I'm at level 10 right now. I'm gonna show you what it's like when you start the game. Alright, and here we are. So this is my character. I'm gonna zoom in just to show you what the graphics are like. So graphically, this game is not particularly super impressive. It does use kind of a low polygon count, and other than texturing, there's really nothing to kind of be impressed about. Music and sound is in the game, and so is basic, really, really basic voice acting. So if I click on this guy, he's gonna tell me how do I do, and also bye-bye. Alright, so basically that's it for graphics and music. I'm not going to say much more about it, because I think it's relatively simple for a game that's coming out in 2015. So really it's all about gameplay, and I'm gonna show you what the gameplay is like. So I'm actually currently controlling my character with WASD. You can control your character with a mouse if you want, but I decided to rebind my keys so that my left mouse button is actually an attack, and so is my right mouse button. What I kind of like about this game so far is that it's going for a mixture of Diablo and a typical Asian MMORPG. So here, there is basically, you'll see there's quite a lot of things borrowed from both genres, and specifically the actual gameplay does feel like Diablo, but at the same time, the way you move and the way the characters look, and even the fact that you have a little pad right here, or the fact that if I were to click on my character, a lot of the abilities, a lot of the stats on my character are kind of like many other Asian MMORPGs. So you'll see a lot of mixture between these two genres. Also the inventory also looks very Korean MMORPG style. Anyway, so let's go inside this first cave. I think we have a quest in there, and I'm gonna try to complete it. And this is some sort of a cavern here where we have to try to, I believe, defeat enemies. There we go, there they come. All right, so I'm gonna show you some of the skills I have. I have this to freeze the enemies. I can then zap them Star Wars style, and I can also use two more abilities which I have here. There's a fireball and lightning strike. So these are your basic abilities for Evoker, and each class gets four basic abilities that you can then upgrade through the skill system. Oh no, they're coming. Here they go. Fry them and run away. So this guy is going to be helping me. I think he's going to be my tank. So yeah, there's quite a complex skill system here. So basically, as you progress through levels, you can choose to specialize in any of the three areas. For this particular class, it's Control, Assault, or Burst. So in other words, Burst increases burst damage, Assault increases your general DPS, and Control increases your crowd control. So, and there's quite a lot of different skills you can actually unlock as you progress through levels. Now let's keep going. We're gonna try to defeat the enemies as they come, and there's a lot of them coming. I'm gonna freeze them and zap them. All in all, the game is not very difficult. I haven't really died yet, even though I know what happens when you die, but so far the game is relatively easy, and in that sense it's actually a lot more akin or similar to Asian RPG games, Asian MMORPG games, than to Diablo, because in Diablo you do die and the game is difficult. Here, however, it's not really that challenging, at least yet. It does get more difficult later on, with especially with some of the tiered quests you start unlocking. Not tiered quests, sorry, tiered dungeons you start unlocking. But for the most part, in the beginning, you're not going to be really struggling that much, and it's not very difficult to level up. One thing I'm not really sure how I feel about in this game is the inventory. So you'll see that I'm picking up these items here. So in other words, inventory here is a little bit different from Diablo. So you'll pick up these items. Some of them will be like special keys for special dungeons. Some of them will be things like megaphones for, you know, chatting with people. And some of them will be actual items you can wear by putting them on your character right here. But the thing is, unlike Diablo, this game doesn't really have a tremendous amount of items to offer you. It's not a loot-based game by any means, and for some of us, especially for me, I guess, it's a little bit disappointing, because I actually wanted this to be a more loot-based game where I can actually collect a bunch of randomly generated loot and then decide what's best for my character based on that. Here, you'll get items once in a while, but they're not going to be particularly interesting, and they're really just sort of like a placeholder for the rest of the game. So this really is more about character progression and skill progression than it is about getting items. So in this game, you're playing as Devillian, which basically stands for a person who's slaughters demons or slaughters devils. So essentially, you're kind of like a witch hunter, but for devils or demons in that case. I guess it's just sort of like lost in translation in there, because I think in Korean, demon and devil, it means the same thing, and in English, it doesn't. So here, your job is to progress through levels and defeat various demons, and as you do so, you obviously level up and you acquire new skills. And as you can see so far, this is really just not particularly challenging game. It's, I mean, all I'm doing is just spamming one of my skills, specifically Fireball, because it does AoE damage. And then once in a while, I'll freeze these guys and I'll use my Lightning Strike on them. And then I basically just, all I have to do is walk away from them once in a while, and then that's it, and they're all dead. It's not particularly challenging, so if you want to play a casual game, if you want to find a casual MMORPG, this is probably one of the best out there. And it is very different from other games, like it's different from games like Rift, of course, and different from other games by Trine Worlds, but at the same time, it does still feel a lot like a typical Asian MMORPG. I wouldn't really even call this a Diablo clone, because it doesn't really feel like it, even though it looks like one. But it's definitely a game that you should consider playing, because, I mean, it's free to play, and there's quite a lot of things to do here. The map in this game is relatively large. I can't really show it to you right now because I'm in a dungeon. Oh, actually, no, never mind. I can't totally show it to you. Here, I'm going to show it to you in a second. I'm going to zoom out here. And so the map is quite large. There's quite a lot of different levels map areas based on the level you are. Some of them are still not accessible because this game is still in beta, but they are accessible in the Korean version, meaning that they're actually out. And you can basically advance through these levels. It's up to level 60 right now, and each of these levels they're relatively small, but each of them has various dungeons as well. So it's not really an open world game, it's more of a level and dungeon based game, but there's quite a lot to do, quite a lot to explore, and quite a lot of enemies to kill. Alright, so we're actually getting some items here. I may want to put some up. Magic defense. Oh, this looks nice. I'll put this on. And then let's get some gloves going. And what's this? Talisman box. And my talisman box gave me a card that gives me magic defense. Ooh, nice. Okay, I'll take that. So there's quite a lot of little things that are typical to Asian And so there's in this game, there's quite a lot of things that are typical to Asian MMORPG games. Like there's actually a daily checklist that rewards you for logging in every day. And you can then basically collect these little tidbits that will reward you with some special items. They're not really particularly powerful or anything, but I guess some of them, like for example, this one here gives you a cute pet box, which is a very, very Asian sort of MMORPG thing to do. I personally am not a particular fan of these, but some people do like them. And so there's a lot of emphasis on, you know, trying to progress through. And so in this game, there's quite a lot of emphasis on collecting cards, collecting pets, collecting little things here and there. So there's quite a lot of different pets you get to unlock. I believe if you pre-purchase this game, you get a pet corgi, which is something that some people enjoy having. And you also get these talismans, which are basically collectible items that you can then place on your character. And you can have up to 5 at level 50, and they do kind of give you extra effects. So this one here gives me more magic defense. And as you collect them, as you get unlock more of them, they'll basically improve your character. Alright, so let's move on. We're gonna try to finish this mission, and I'll show you what the boss fights are like. So usually at the end of every dungeon, there's going to be like a boss fight or some sort of final fight that's a little bit more challenging than other fights. I think this is possibly it. No, actually, no, that's not it. This is just a sub-fight, sub-level that is a little bit easier. And there you go, this guy's dead. Did not take much from me to defeat him. And I get some sort of evoker item. Excellent, perfect. All right, moving on. So let's... Oh, there's a quest marker right here, so this is where I have to go. Go to a suspicious spot. And I think this is the boss. Sometimes you get to see cutscenes as well. Like in this case, I'm saving someone.
If you're not a devil, then help me! Oh, destroy the energy siphons! I can't do anything while they're on!
And I think this cutscene kind of gave you an idea that this is really an Asian MMORPG. The graphics are reminiscent of games like Lineage, and if you kind of try to look at this from the perspective of Lineage, there's a lot of similarities to that game, except of course it's much, much easier. Alright, so let's destroy these things. I think this is one of the last quests in this particular level, and we're gonna try to defeat these guys and finish the mission. Okay, so looks like I've completed the quest. Let's see what happens next. I've saved Bolton, and now
I still feel weak, but I can't abandon my mission. Please help me.
All right, we have to help him complete the mission. Looks like we probably have to defeat someone. And unfortunately, with cutscenes, that's really when you get to see that the graphics in this game are kind of disappointing for a 2015 game. It's not really the best asset of this game, but on the other hand, this also means that you can play this game on much slower, much older computers, which is, I think, why Trine Worlds decided to choose this game for their next release, as opposed to some other games that they could have chosen from South Korea. There's actually quite a lot of MMORPGs in South Korea that are much more popular than Devillian right now, and I think they decided to go with this game because mostly because it's original, but also because the requirements for this game are much lower than for some of the other MMORPG games. Alright, so the arrows are leading us to this big room, which is, I'm guessing, where the final boss fight is going to be. And here it comes. Phoenix Lair. Phoenix spelled without the O, that's okay, I'll forgive them. And this is the final boss. Alright, following the cheesy cutscene, let's actually just destroy this guy, because I'm pretty sure he's not going to be super difficult. I'm going to freeze them and use electricity. So because there is a guy helping me, tank guy helping me, I'm not going to be really struggling too much with this fight, because this boss will never really even make it to me. There's actually three characters right now, two of them are NPCs, and both of them are helping me with this boss fight. Okay, and boss is done, and we leveled up, got level 12 now, and this is the end of this quest. And mission complete. So now we just have to talk to Bolton and he'll give us rewards for defeating the monster and give us a new quest probably. And because I've just completed that quest, it has given me a new ability of transforming into the Devillian, which is basically like a sort of like a superpower where I become sort of like this character right here. I become a devil-like apparition that gets a little bit more strength. But to get that, I need to actually first fill up this gauge by destroying various monsters. Now, essentially, this game is really simple. And this is basically the essence of this game. So my new quest now takes me to a training ground portal. And also, I need to spend an extra point to acquire a new skill so that I can actually complete that quest as well. All in all, this game is actually pretty nice. I think there's quite a lot of things going on here, and because it's free to play, I think it's definitely going to be quite popular for quite a while once it comes out. Anyway, I think I'm going to stop this here. If you guys have any questions, or if you would like me to make another video featuring something else in this game, let me know in the comments below. I think I'm going to pause this video, and hopefully you enjoyed this. If you did, please subscribe and like this video, and I'm going to see you in the next one. Game you later, guys, and bye-bye.